Went wrong way. Is Flobor?
No. Why are you dressed like that?
I wasn't planning on visiting the 19th century.
Click on the rope. And just as if by magic...
What was that noise?
What noise? I didn't hear a noise.
The noise of... me. Yeah, I couldn't think of anything good to say. And the dog is being a bitch.
Okay, that was lucky.
Won't be long now.
We'll just see.
I'll bring down his chandelier.
Ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
100 years from now, Hill Valley will erect a statue in my honor.
You're joking, right? A statue for you? No. Mouse, stop moving.
The ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
Yeah, how?
The sandbag's right over Tannen's head.
Yeah, I know. How do I bloody drop it? What's for that?
Are you here to haul me back to 1931 for my supposed crimes? Or is there some sort of time court for that kind of thing?
Time?
Come on.
Got any last words?
I'll see you in hell, Tannen.
You first, lady.
Come on, you son of a...
Oh!
Who the hell are you?
I'm the diversion, butthead.
Nice one.
Nice one, Doc.
Don't tell Clara. She thinks Fisticuffs set a bad example for the boys. Now, where's Edna?
Doc, she's gone.
Seriously?
Edna's DeLorean.
We gotta stop her before she hits 88 miles per hour. Come on.
Go, go, go. Do I have to drive?
Nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
Haha! This one can fly.
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate to 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we gonna stop her?
Good question. Can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self put all over her DeLorean have given me an idea. Here, take these.
Oh, what are they?
What are these?
Flux synchronization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes, but we might be able to use them to sync up with the alternate DeLorean's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
Got a little theory.
That's a great plan,
right?
I think.
Can we try
Best of
it
all,
then?
We won't need to weld the modules to the frame. I just snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Good question. Let me think.
Aha!
You got my hoverboard. Yeah, hoverboard!
Hoverboard!
It saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet!
What is that?
You okay?
It's just like riding a bike.
Yeah.
Ready to make the jump?
Ready, Doc.
Let's go!
1, 2, 3, jump! Whoa. Nice form, buddy. Out of reception on the wire.
Where'd you get these?
From Burns' cache of 21st century video game consoles. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach modules to those diagnostic lights.
Will do, Doc.
How do I do that without realizing? You cannot see me.
Is this the starboard flux emitter?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
All right.
Nicely done. Now aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here.
Great. Stay. No.
Yay!
I think. She's a bit of a bitch.
Great, that's one flux sink down. Two to go.
Two? Fuck.
I better not touch it now that it's synced.
Oh, do we have to... Okay. Oh, let's get the one on the
top. Is that one of the flux emitters?
Yes, now plug in the flux sink.
No, I don't want hints. Got a windscreen wiper. I have a feeling that's going to come in useful at some point.
I can't reach it from here!
You just have to climb onto the top.
Mr. Fusion! Should I disable it?
Leave it alone! It's not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
Yeah. How do I get up onto the top?
It's one of the flux emitters! Not sure what that'll do.
Oh! Get off!
It's one of the flux emitters!
Yes, I know it's one of the flux emitters!
On the front. So she does that. Really? Well, that's somewhat useful. But no, there's a big...
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
Great.
Marty!
I'm okay.
Hey, look at on top.
It's locked!
See if we can do anything you... some uncomfortable as we can.
Nice work, Marty.
On the driver's side, and then work our way over to here without you noticing, because you don't have a mirror because you fucked it up because you're
made
stupid.
It.
Now let's get that bunch of bright marshmallow before she starts making life difficult.
She's been making it easy up till now? Is that the port flux emitter?
Yes, now plug in the flux sink.
Flux sink.
Well, here goes nothing, Doc.
Now I have to sink
Whoa.
It.
Perfect! Now, aim the flux sink towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish, check!
Stop moving!
We're almost home, Marty. Just one flux sink left.
you hooligan!
It ain't your car, actually.
So, it's one of the flux emitters.
I have no idea how to climb on top.
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Marty, are you alright?
Well...
Not really.
What?
Pull over!
No!
Why?
Excellent.
There's one way to get on top.
Now that you're on top of the board, and you can attach the flux sink to the overhead flux emitter.
It's great, Doc.
Dilly, get our priorities straight. We have to connect this thing. Don't worry about tunnel.
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
Oh, we're upside down.
And there's been the other way around.
Ah! Whew!
That's it. Frank. Get out of there, buddy!
Phew.
Thanks, Doc. You saved my life again.
Now what?
Now we take control of that into the oil with the flux synchronizers. That's strange.
What?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home. Now!
Well, first time I've heard that in the swamp. Surprised you survived that. 70 mile an hour into a wall, without airbags.
Parker. Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
What? No! You can't arrest me. Not now. I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
Why are you still worried? Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it. Unhand me, you dolt.
Oh, well, that was perfect.
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do you do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker! You're not gonna believe this!
See? What did I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc! The timeline's not fixed yet. Look! Sonny! You missed all the fireworks at the expo.
Ugh, something about
Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! thought he took me to Reno last night.
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you're gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, are you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
This just isn't right. Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
I'm not disappearing
isn't it just
yet, though.
The sweetest.
You're too young!
Artie, you can't do this. You're not supposed to get married for another 5 years.
Well, I know Trixie and I were taking things slow.
But after that witch Edna got me fired with that postcard, we kind of accelerated things a little.
The postcard? Oh, man.
Am I fading out? No.
Can you see through me?
Nope. Never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
I knew it.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did you?
I knew it.
Don't
I called it from the minute that I heard that this
you had a thing. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. Your Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so skinny and blonde and...
Yeah,
you know,
it's amazing
what
oh my God.
You as a brunette.
Do for I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
Are you okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around. Come around to what? To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
I am McFly. In case you haven't noticed, we're quite similar in looking.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Crockett.
Agent? Still. Oh, thanks.
See you in the funny paper, Sonny.
Bye, Grandma.
He walks exactly the same as me.
You know,
great grandpa, Willie.
Pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
Oh wow.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean...
Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc.
What was that?
Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Just
speaking
noise.
Of which, did you find what you were looking for?
Yes.
Yeah, I sure did.
Great. Hey, is that a box of Asimov?
Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you.
Ooh, gifts, presents.
Happy graduation.
What?
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlies of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under her stage name?
Hmm. This is great, Doc. Thanks.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Well. Dr. Brown!
Uh-oh.
Edna?
Well, she's looking...
Tiny!
What's going on? What are you doing with my dog?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
What?
Dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly. Hi, Marty.
I have no
Don't
idea.
Don't they make a great little family?
What?
You never know, they met in prison.
What's going on?
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
Marty's face says it all for me right now. That is my face.
Doc!
Marty! What are you doing here?
You gotta come with me! Back to the future!
Marty, you can't be here! If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right! Bring him along, too. This concerns all of us.
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Yeah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
Great Scott!
Ooh, blue. I like blue.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back to listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you want to save Jennifer and our 12 kids...
What? That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back. Jennifer's out.
How can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My own rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rack right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up, and you gotta come with me to save it. No, me!
So, we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands.
Just a little.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Martin? Come on!
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future?
And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
You sound broken, but it is the end. But everything. That's the end. That's it. You end up back to the future. No more. Bloody hell. That ending was a bit strange. I'm a little confused at the ending. Also, I'm a little confused as to the DeLorean was destroyed in the films, but it's in the game. Still functioning. But yeah, that was interesting. It's amazing what you find when you look on stores. I'll say this, I found this on the Oxcat stores. I don't know the about, I found this, so I got it. What make a good video? And it's been interesting, it's been fun. Now, what to do next? I'll think about something. I'm not laughing, I think I'm doing Hitman. I might do Hitman. But yeah, I have shit tons of messages on my phone. Well, actually, I say shit tons of phone. Yeah. Michael J. Fox.
I knew it was you. Brian Floyd.
Kid Beyond. Wow.
Well, I'm getting spammed to go on fighting the fan war, so we're gonna end this episode here. So we're gonna head.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching. If any of you has watched all the way through episode 1 to 1, thank you for watching so much so far. Yeah, if you've got any other games you want me to play, then go ahead, suggest me. I'll see every one of you very soon when I play World of Living Games again. So yes, thank you so much for watching. See you guys very soon. Hope your phone hit the like button. And yes, I will see you soon. I really need to watch this.
Thanks for watching.
And goodbye! When the music stops.
Really?